These toilet paper tube faces started out for me as an accident that was created out of frustration. And I identified the face and worked with it a little bit more, and here came my first toilet paper tube face. Then I did a bit of research and found out it's actually kind of a thing. So let's explore a little bit more the toilet tube paper faces and what we can do with them to create a piece of art for our studios. Let me first explain who I am. I have been drawing a prompt each month and then working with that prompt for 4 weeks. This month I drew toilet paper and toilet paper tubes. So we are going to wrangle this toilet paper tube a bit and create a face. And I'll show you how I created the blue and red one up above. I sprayed it, spritzed it with a little bit of water to make it more pliable. Not too much. You don't want to completely and totally saturate the toilet paper tube or it will fall apart on you. But just enough to make it more pliable and more movable. Then you just start to envision that face. I began working with the nose because that gives me a good start. This is my nose. And now I'm pushing in the sides to create the cheeks. Giving it a fold for the mouth and a fold for the brow line. And I'll just put on a little bit of music and let you watch the wrangling and the painting of this toilet paper tube face.
You look at me like I'm crazy. When I shut my feelings out, you look at me like I'm different. Still you stay cause you feel something real. Get so lost in my moments. Doesn't mean I don't need you. I fell in love with your colors. They kinda tell me what I'm thinking. I fell in love with the way we are and the way we lose it. There's something different about us. They never know where we will fall. Nobody can see us. Still they wanna tear us apart. There's something different about the way we are. Cup after cup, yeah, it's just the way we do it. Anything just to block out the real life, real life. Yeah, we're loving the way they think we're so messed up, up. Even if what we're doing is bad, there's so many emotions. Sharing stories that we never had, yet none is real. I think we're searching for reasons not to be like them. We fly around like paper planes. They never know where we will fall. Nobody can see us. Still they wanna tear us apart. There's something different about the way we are. Are.
now that I have this completely painted inside out, front, back, I want to protect it with a coat of Mod Podge hard coat. And I think this adds stability to it. I think it forms it into place and gives it that clink when you drop this toilet paper roll. So I am very fond of the Mod Podge hard coat. I'm going to let that dry. And once dry, I have these leaves that I did in the index card project. I think that was in December, that I pressed, dried, and now I'm pulling them to use them in yet another project. And I think this makes a nice little crown or a nice little hair representation on the top of this toilet paper tube face. I will coat that with the Mod Podge hard coat to just protect the leaf. I'm going to coat this, and then I'm going to hang it up to dry. And once it is dry, I will insert it into the tube and glue it in for our hair. So now let's create something to put these tubes on, these face tubes. And I kind of am thinking maybe a totem pole type look, but not necessarily a totem pole. Just something to represent these faces. So I pulled a piece of cardboard. This is the flap on a cardboard box. I exposed some of the cordage on other pieces, or you know, pulled back to make sure I could get that ruffled look, if you will. I'm gluing these together with my water and glue mixture. And then I'm going to paint and decorate. You can see me expose that right there, and we'll just add one or two. So I'm looking for two things here. I'm looking for stability, one, and I'm looking for interest and texture and something to, kind of pull your eye in a little closer, because you're going to be looking at this, looking at the toilet paper tube faces and analyzing and identifying that, yeah, that does look like a face, hopefully. And then, you know, I want you to just look a little bit deeper into this and look at the background a little bit. So let's create an interesting background of sort to mount these toilet paper tube faces on. So this is how I envisualize them kind of appearing. We have the representation of the primary colors, red, yellow, and blue, and we'll place those on top of each other on this cardboard strip. I am going to make that strip dark. I'm starting with raw umber, and I will coat the whole thing in raw umber. I'm being careful when I paint this to kind of turn my brush sideways and get down in between those little divots to make sure that everything is covered. There's no real cardboard look peeking through. And we'll consume quite a bit of paint on this because this is very absorbent. So I'm using an inexpensive paint to get this covered. And there, we have everything covered. I'm kind of going down the sides, making sure that the sides are covered as well. And once that is dry, I shall flip this over and just collage the back. I have pulled out some scrap gel press prints that I didn't use in other projects. I'm going to rip and tear those and just collage them onto the back of this strip of cardboard that we are utilizing to mount our toilet paper tube faces. And we just about have that complete. And I did speed this up because this is nothing more than me pasting paper or gluing paper onto the back of this project. And I've trimmed it up once it was dry. And now we have the front in that raw umber, and the back is completely collaged in paper. I am adding some gray-green to the front, and I'm just placing that erratically, I guess would be the best word to use, on the front of this cardboard background. And that is absorbing and drying very quickly. And I just want to place these little toilet tube pieces to see how they're going to look. And I'm not putting my yellow ochre one on there because it's not yet dry. And I have pulled out the luster wax, the gold luster wax, and am putting that around on this piece as well. Now, all of these supplies you can find on my channel, or not on my channel, but on my website, Two Old Crows Mix Media, under crafting supplies, and you can, I have it put in categories by tools and paint and different products, and you can find just about everything I use there. I do make a small commission on that, but it just kind of organizes it for you. It does not raise your price. Now that I have that complete, I'm going around the outside edge in black to just kind of add that shadow effect on the edges. And to shore it up a bit, I have pulled out some popsicle sticks or some craft sticks. I have taken them over and stained them. I took them over to my encaustic wax station where I do have shellac and stain, and stained all these popsicle sticks. And I'm just gluing them every 4 centimeters to just make sure that this is a piece that doesn't fold like cardboard normally folds, and it just shores it up a bit. Once I get these all down, they're flush on one side but jagged on the other, I will put some weight on this with a couple of books and a brick. Once they're dried, I will come back and trim that edge so everything is flush and everything looks real nice. So we'll let those dry, and then we will come back and get our toilet tube faces ready to be adhered. I have the dried leaves now. They've all been mud podged with that hard coat. I'm gluing them down to create a face, or create the hair for this face, if you will. And then I will pull out my liquid pearls and put just a little definition at the top. Now I think he's looking pretty smart. Now let's give him a little bit of a gold halo with some gold liquid pearls. And of course they've been sitting for a while, so I'm going to have to get my pen and kind of loosen that up so we can get this out. There we go. I think we have it now. Maybe needs another stick with this pen. I should have edited this out. I'm sorry, but we're already this far in with the voiceover, so we'll leave it in, and you can see my frustration with things that bind up on me. So let's get that ready. And I'll go ahead and do that to the yellow ochre guy. I'll add his hair with the leaves. I'll add the leaf hair to my blue gentleman as well. And we'll kind of line them up and find out where they should rest or live on this cardboard backing. And then we'll get to work on putting them all down. So everybody has their hair now and is ready to be put into place. Just make some minor adjustments and give everyone a little bit of those liquid pearls. We're going to do that as well. But let's get the first one down. I'm going to put the glue everywhere it looks like it will butt up against that background and glue him into place. That glue sets up very fast. So while that is drying, I'm going to punch my holes on that embellishment and take these gold brads and secure those into place. And we'll do that on the next two gents as well. So now we have all three firmly in place, and it's just time to do a little bit of finish work. And I'm going to grab that gold luster wax and just kind of go around the outside edges and give it just a little bit more pizzazz. And that completes this toilet paper tube project for the first toilet paper tube prompt in this month. The next 3 months will also be something that originates from either toilet paper or a toilet paper tube. Please take a moment and take a photo of the faces that you create if you do so, and bring them over and post either on Instagram with coffee cup prompts as your hashtag, or tag me so that I am able to see them. I would love to see what you come up with. This was a very simple project. If you want to join us over at Two Old Crows Mix Media in Facebook, there's a group over there as well. Please stop by, post your work there too. Once again, thank you for subscribing to my channel. Thanks for being here and supporting me. I appreciate it. I love the comments. I always read them. And I shall say bye for now. See you next week with another toilet paper tube or toilet paper project.